reunite. How the bonds of Semper Fidelis will be reforged 10 years after Iraqi freedom for a former Lubbock Marine.
Now, fracking for oil on Lubbock's north side is taking on a more environmentally friendly approach.
Why sipping your refreshing soft drink may cost you a penny more. I'm Henry Ramos. I'll tell you why a Texas lawmaker filed a bill that would put a tax on sugary drinks like Coke.
It's 9 o'clock, and you are watching Fox 34 News at 9.
A big old gulp of your favorite sugary drink, like a classic Coca-Cola, may one day cost you some extra pennies.
A San Antonio Democratic lawmaker says he has the solution to funding public education and promote a healthier lifestyle, a tax on those sugary drinks like soda. Our Henry Ramos takes a swig of the proposal.
State Representative Joe Farias has a twist to fund public education. He's proposing a penny per ounce tax on sugary drinks like soda.
There's a dire need to have money for our school districts.
Farias says the tax could earn up to $2 billion, which he proposes would go to the Children Health Promotion Account, Texas Education Agency, and State Health Services. He hopes to fight obesity in children.
Aid in the prevention or the assistance in helping students that suffer from diabetes and prevent heart conditions that currently exist in a lot of our children, especially in the area that I represent in Southern Bexar County and San Antonio.
Under the bill, there would be drinks tax exempt, items like coffee, your zero-calorie diet drinks, even those fruit drinks, and last but not least, those sports drinks. I think that's a good route to go on taxing sodas and sugary drinks?
No, I don't like taxes generally.
I think we're taxed enough, so I don't think I'd be for it.
You drink what you want to drink, you eat what you want to drink, and that's et cetera, et cetera. That's it.
But I don't think that the sugary drinks would be the way to go about that.
I think that would be a good idea.
You think it's a great idea? Why is that?
Well, sugary drinks aren't good for any of us. Maybe it could do some good in education.
If you have not quit smoking because of tax, they haven't quit drinking alcohol or liquor because of tax, I don't think we're not trying to prevent people from drinking soda water. If that's what you want to have, fine.
This is the second time Farias has tried to tax Texas soda sales. His 2011 effort failed to make it out of committee, and the need for funding makes him more optimistic this go-around. With photojournalist Andrew Wood, Henry Ramos, Fox 34, News at 9.
According to the Centers for Disease Control, approximately 17%, 12.5 million children, adolescents aged 2 to 19 years of age are obese. Since 1980, obesity prevalence among children and adolescents has almost tripled. Farias also cites his reasoning with a review conducted by Yale University's Rudd Center for Food Policy and Obesity. It claims for every 10% price increase in tobacco, consumption decreases by 7.8%.